Hi Aries, welcome back to Omkara Tarot, and let's do another reading for you. This is going to be an energy check-in, Aries, between you and the person who's affecting your energy the most right now. Okay, so let's begin. My angel spirit guides, bless this reading for my Aries gang and send them the messages they need to hear the most right now. Thank you. So Aries, without wasting any more time, let's get on with your reading and see what is it that we need to know now. Aries and the person who's affecting their energy the most right now. Okay, and this is your person. And action you want to take, action they want to take. Okay, Aries, so either something is coming to a complete ending or maybe a big transformation coming into your life. Okay, so I'm going to start with a few dialogue message cards before I tell you what's going on here. But the overall gist of what I get is somebody is for me, this is person A, right? This is person B. So you could be on either side. You will have to know. So the basic gist that I'm getting here, Aries, is that somebody was in a toxic relationship, or that's how they felt, and they are ready to release maybe the toxic relationship or some toxicity in the relationship because they never found victory in it. They were never truly happy and they were just kind of wasting time. Right now, person A has kind of lost their love and they are no longer wanting to even communicate with person B. Person B is seeing, yes, this person A is no longer messaging them, talking to them, no longer giving their nurturing and loving to them. They see them as being very, very defensive. And because person A has been so defensive, this person is coming to some kind of a truth and clarity about why this has happened. Now, person B is sitting in their regret and thinking of coming forward with a romantic love offer. Okay, of course, I'll clarify these cards later. Let's take a few dialogue message cards and see what's the real problem here. So, one card from here, Spirit. One card. Okay. And let's take a couple from here. Okay. And I'm going to take a couple from here. Okay, I think they're good. Aries, let's start our reading. If only you knew what I have been through to be at your side. Do you really know the sacrifices I have made? It hurts like hell when you push me away, when all I do is fight for you and our love. Maybe that was the issue. Somebody never felt victorious in a connection. They never really were in that space where they were truly happy. Maybe at that point, person B was always pushing them away, always delaying the connection. And slowly and steadily, I think person A has withdrawn their love and no longer even wanting to talk about it. So let's put this here. The second card says, I'm not sure if you love me for me or who you think I am. Self-worth issues on the other side, I think. They always maybe felt people wanted them for their big cars or money or their status or whatever, and never believed that they were lovable. And that's the reason maybe they kept pushing person A away. Sometimes because I know we will be together, I take you for granted. Sometimes because I know we will be together, I take you for granted. This may have been something one of you said to the other person and saying, hey, listen, I don't have time for you right now. We'll catch up later. Or if, I know after so many years also, you're going to stick around. Where are you going to go? Right? So maybe this person was overconfident, over cocky, and felt their partner's never going to leave them. You deserve to be loved. You are very special. I think now that person A has removed their energy, person B is now coming to that clarity as to what did I do to push person A away, and why person A is being that defensive now. I have commitment issues. Maybe that's the reason they kept pushing person A away. Because they felt if you get too close, and I may have to say something, and even though they knew this was a special connection, they didn't want commitment right now. Maybe they thought they can keep it for 5 years later, 10 years later. But now I think something has happened. Person A has kind of totally withdrawn their love, totally withdrawn their energy, and now person B, I think, is feeling the regret and sorrow about that. Last card says, you are the most beautiful creature I have ever seen. Yes, now the clarity is there. But is it too late? I don't know. I've still kept these two cards here to see what will be the most likely outcome that both of you will take towards each other. But you know me, Aries, before I start clarifying these cards, I am going to take one angel blessing card to top the reading so that we get a blessing, advice, guidance, or a message from the universe. For Aries spirit, Aries, miracle. All right, Aries, a miracle is on the way, one way or the other. Okay, I don't know whether it's going to be reuniting with your person that's going to be a miracle, or maybe you finally finding your freedom and breaking away from them. But a miracle is guaranteed for my Aries gang. So let's put this beautiful card here and see what's going on here. Okay, so let's start with the energies of person Aries. I have the Devil and the Six of Wands. So this is how person A is feeling at the moment. They feel that I can never have victory in this connection. So what am I holding on to? All this pain, sorrow, all the upset, and they actually started to feel, I think, that their person was a very toxic person in their life. They want to break away. They want to break the chains of this connection, because somehow person A has never felt victorious in this connection. They always feel that each time they've tried, they've failed. And this is an active choice, I think, being made by person A, that I want to release this connection. I don't want to be in it anymore. Am I right, spirit? Yes, even though this was such a beautiful connection, right? Such a beautiful, they feel the love, they felt the love, they felt the connection, they felt this is a soulmate connection. Both these cards are signifying the same thing, Aries, the Two of Cups and the Lovers. But somehow, whatever was toxic in this relationship has not made this connection grow. There has been no victory till now. That's how at least person A is feeling. So, what happened in the past, spirit, for them to feel like that? The Sun in reverse and the Nine of Pentacles in reverse. So what happened in the past to make person A feel like that? They felt things never really grew. There was no happiness here. There was no emotional Ten of Cups feeling. Maybe they both knew, or at least person A knew, that this is my soulmate, this is the person I've been guided to. Maybe they were getting signs and synchronicities that person B is their person, but somehow they never felt that connection grow with the person B. They always felt, I'll never have wish fulfillment, and because this person never chooses. They always stay in a state of confusion. Maybe they had many options, and because they never chose person A, straight off, there was no real happiness in this connection. Yes, it was always imbalanced. Always a very imbalanced feeling, never feeling that, you know, we are on the same page and we can grow. And this was creating too much delay for person A. Nine of Pentacles in reverse. They felt it's just taking too long. And that's the reason, I think, in the recent past, person A decided to leave all this trouble behind and move on to, you know, maybe their own journey to find peace and happiness elsewhere. One more card, spirit, for the Nine of Pentacles. Yes, maybe there could have been a fight as well. Maybe this was a sudden decision made by person A. This is like fast moving action to cut away things from the past, because now they decided, hey, there's no point investing, no point wasting time. All the time, effort, love that I've invested in this connection has gone nowhere. Okay, so I'm not going to sit in this delay for any longer. I'm going to take off. And this was maybe a very sudden decision made by person A. So how do they feel about person B now, Spirit? How does person A feel about person B? Of course, Aries, this side could be you or that side could be you. You would know. Right now, they're not feeling very loved up, to be honest. Ace of Cups is in reverse. I think they're slowly losing the strength to even carry on feeling any love for person B. This love is kind of ebbing away. They're losing their feeling now for person B. Maybe there's been a lack of communication for a long time. So at least person B has actually kind of decided to put a halt to this relationship for now and no longer communicate with person B. Anything else, Spirit, for their feelings towards person B? Yes, person B in a very good light. Maybe they feel that their partner is kind of a dictator. It's always their way or the highway, and they've always kind of put them down. They never make them feel that they are, equal to them, maybe, or maybe just kind of hurt them, even if there's no need. They always kind of bring down the energy and walk away laughing, right? So person B has stopped communicating because they say, what's the point? Every time we talk, we fight, and it's better not to talk. At least that way there'll be no conflict in my life. I can't deal with any more conflict. I want to leave all this conflict behind and move to a happier space for myself. So the best way would be to stop communication, right? And because there's been no communication, this person A is slowly losing their love, maybe, or it's kind of the feelings are dying, as I can see. So let's see person B now. How are they feeling right now? Person B has the Queen of Pentacles in reverse and the Page of Wands. So now they feel that their partner has turned their back on them totally. They feel that person is no longer giving that love and affection. There's no more nurturing coming from person A side. There is no messaging happening. There's nobody making a movement towards them anymore. Maybe in the past, person A was always kind of over-loving, nurturing, kind, supportive. And now they're feeling it big time. Now, as much as person B is wanting to, they're still passionate about person A. I don't know about the love bit, but person B is still kind of wanting this passionate new beginning with person A. But here they are, stressed out, overthinking. Why? Because they feel that person A has already turned their back and is now the Queen of Pentacles in reverse. Somebody who doesn't want to grow with them. Somebody who doesn't want to have abundance in love and life with them anymore. So now they don't know what message to send, how to say it, because they're overthinking the situation. They're not used to maybe being the one who's always been the giver, right? They're not used to being the giver. They're always used to being the taker. And now since person A has stopped giving, this person is now stuck. So what happened in the recent past, Spirit, for this situation to happen? Seven of Wands and the Ace of Swords. Yeah, somebody was, I think, pretty overburdened, overwhelmed. Maybe at that point they had too many responsibilities in their life, or they didn't want to take on another one. And they got a little misguided as well, I think. Maybe they talked to some people or somebody gave them some wrong advice. This person was guided in the wrong direction and they ended up kind of blocking this connection. Am I right, Spirit? What's this Seven of Wands again? Yes, they were being a bit selfish in the past. They never took action when the time was right. Maybe it was all about them, about their wishes, their dreams. And this person ended up not taking action when the time was right. And now here they sit in regret and sorrow for what they've done. And not just once, Aries, this person has the same card twice. So this is the amount of regret and sorrow person B is going through about a missed opportunity. So, Ace of Swords spirit, what's that? Ace of Swords. This is like an epiphany or some truth which has been revealed. They realize now that they were the cause of this tower falling, Aries. This could be you again, right? Person B knows that they've come to that realization now. It's become clear, the fog has cleared. They know that, oh my God, it's because of me and all my broken promises. All my broken promises that this tower fell. I never lived up to what I should have done. Like when the tower is in reverse, it's the person knowing that they're probably the cause of the tower falling. And now they're coming to this realization is because they feel they're all words and no action. They never kind of did what they were supposed to do. So now this person once again sits in their Five of Cups, feeling regret, sorrow, feeling everything is lost, and they can't see anything positive now because of what they've done. How do they see person A spirit? How does person A see person B see person A now? What are their feelings towards person A? The way they feel about person A, Aries, is that Aries is now moving off. Person A is moving off. They are kind of now thinking of what is next. They feel person A has the world in their hands. They can choose whoever they want. They don't have to come back to them. They have multiple choices maybe, or maybe the world in their hands, right? Look at this person with the world in their hands, looking at the horizon and saying, hey, I have choices now. I can do whatever I want. I can go wherever I want. I'm not subject to my past. So now this person is feeling deep regret because they feel that person A looks at them as a trickster, doesn't have any faith in them. And that's kind of making person B feel totally left out and abandoned and sad. And they also see person A coming out of this energy. They feel person A is not feeling the loss of this connection anymore. Knight of Cups spirit. What's this Knight of Cups? Knight of Cups. The way they feel about person A is that they have to say something. They have to do something to rectify the situation. They are hoping to maybe get some romance back into this connection. They are realizing now why person A has left. It was because there was no equal give and take. Remember I talked about this person was a taker and this person was a giver. They're kind of recognizing that and why person A has walked away from the connection. Now they're recognizing, what's this Knight of Cups spirit? Knight of Cups. Yes, they're recognizing why this person is not giving to the connection. The Queen of Pentacles once again. They feel, you know, they are recognizing that maybe I was just kind of all words, all sweetness, all romance, but never really stepping up to the plate. And they're also kind of feeling that the person A will no longer be interested if they come forward now with a romantic offer. Okay, so let's see, what is the action person A would like to take towards person B now, spirit? Nothing. They want to be in hermit mode. I think they are by themselves. Person A is by themselves. They are kind of, they've got a lot of spiritual knowledge now. They're trying to understand why this connection happened, what happened, but they're also feeling, hey, the worst is over now. And person A is ready to shut this chapter down. They're ready for a brand new beginning in their life. After going through all this misery of rejection, dejection, feeling sad, feeling, you know, left behind, all that is now coming to a close because I think person A has made a decision now and they've done it after some time. There's been a delay in leaving this connection because they've really had to go within and understand what was their role in this delay. What did they do? Why did they allow it? And what they mustn't do the next time around maybe. So after being in hermit mode, the worst is over for person A. Now they are shutting this chapter and probably starting a brand new one. So spirit, is it going to be with person B or elsewhere? Or is this going to be a new? No, I don't think so, Aries. Person A thinks this person B is very immature. Yes, this is not their wish fulfillment. They want somebody to who can match their energy. At the moment, person A feels person B is like a gossipy person or very immature or a trickster or mischievous character who can't do right towards them. This is not their wish fulfillment at the moment, at least, because now the love is lost from person A's side. Let's see the action person B would like to take towards person A. Knight of Swords in reverse. They want to come and have a fight. What's the action person B would like to take, spirit, towards person A? One more. They want to come and fight with person B. Sorry, person B would like to come and come. This is their feeling right now. They are finding a way, or maybe there's a lot of frustration on person B's side. They are willing to, they feel that person A is very angry, upset, and almost like the B word, right? They're feeling that this person is bitter, angry, upset, and they want to match this energy now. Why? Because I think they've been overthinking it. They haven't been able to sleep at night. They haven't been able to work. And they just want an outlet for their frustration, which has been building up. They know this relationship is kind of over, but they feel they must have their last say towards person B, who they feel has sneaked away from them, escaped them. So am I right, spirit? Sideways cards I don't like. This is crucial, spirit. Anything else for Aries? Aries, I want you to be very, very careful now. This person is still... They are still stuck. They're still stuck in their negative energy, very low vibration at the moment. Try and avoid this person at all costs. I mean, I've never seen such an energy. Wheel of Fortune in reverse, the Devil with the Knight of Swords, with the Three of Pentacles in reverse, with the Nine of Swords in reverse, with the Queen of Swords in reverse, with the Ten of Swords in reverse, and then the Liar, Cheater, Sneak. Okay, so I think the frustration level has gone up to that extent now that it's better to stay away from this energy for the time being. Whoever's on person A's side, I think you're doing the right thing. You continue on your journey and miracles are coming your way. That's that much I... What's this miracle? Okay, let's get some good news as well. What's this miracle that Aries can expect, spirit? What's this miracle? What's this miracle that Aries can expect now, spirit? What's this miracle that Aries can expect? What's this miracle that Aries can expect, Spirit? Ten of Pentacles. You don't give up, Aries. Keep yourself protected. Keep yourself guarded. Maybe in the past you probably felt like the six of wands, right? Here this was your card earlier. Spirit is saying if you've been feeling this way, a miracle is headed your way, which is going to give you the Ten of Pentacles. So this could be some great news coming towards you, Aries. This could be in finances, work, stability, home. You keep at it. Do not give up. Okay, this is a person who's been battered and bruised and ready to fight one more day, and it's like almost like about to reach the finish line for your own success and happiness. So whatever this person wants to do, keep calm, take a deep breath. You're in the hermit mode right now. Keep that energy going. Okay, all right. So that's all I have for you, Aries. I hope you enjoyed your reading. Do let me know. Till next time then, love and light. Take care. Namaste.